Ja, 15. Oh, lovely.
Okay, perfetto. Quindi adesso vado, I go to zero.
Ja. Okay, 16. Record it.
I made my first piece, my first solo, when I was 28, which is quite late. And I think it changes your ideas about what you can do. You have a different perspective on it when you start much older. So I was never going to compete technically with anybody, because technically I can't. I started too late.
Are there any little girls in the house? Are there any little angels in the house? Any poppets? Pumpkins? Princesses? Well, are there? Are there?
When I was 60, actually, I decided to restart my live career again. Everybody else hangs up their shoes. But I did the opposite. Because I'd been making a lot of films up to that point, 10 years before, and then I thought, no, I want to go back on the stage. I want to go back, and I want to be the visible older woman. I want to reclaim the stage space for the older woman. I want to have a voice for the older woman on this live stage. And I think, you know, I allowed myself finally to say I was an artist, but I didn't. It felt like that I couldn't say that for so many years.
Now I have children of my own, all aborted and all alone. They ask, will I be Skirt Sheila, Posh Totty or Bane, Bag Ho or Bimbo, from Dish Day or Doll, Mother or Minna or Mummy or Man, a killer of babies left out in a pram, helpless, hopeless, imprisoned or free, graceless, charmless, bone idle, or mean, a handmaid, a mute, inert, undersold, lacking ambition, cheap, but not old. Here's what she said to me.
You know, I can hear my parents saying, stop showing off. Oh, you're just showing off. And so you try to please other people. And I think when I hit a certain age, and particularly in my late 50s into my 60s, I decided to please myself, and I gave myself permission. And that's when I decided, yes, I was an artist. I have permission finally. I give myself permission, and that's what I do. That's what I am. But I didn't think it for many years before, even though I was being an artist. Funny, isn't it? I don't... Strange that you... It takes so long. I don't know if it's a female thing. I don't know if... I don't know if I was just more insecure about admitting those things as a woman. I don't know.
Millions of people have milked at my breast. No doubt you think that is strange. Being a woman, I cleared up the mess. And now I could do with some change. Oh. Oh.
If anybody would have said, what do you think you'll be doing when you're 60? I'm 65 now. What will you be doing when you're 65? I wouldn't imagined, I wouldn't have thought I'd be doing this. I had no kind of sense that in when I was young that I would still be doing it, because there's an assumption when you get to a particular age that you retire or you do something else or you slow down. But I found the opposite. I have more energy to do this now. There are more things I want to say on stage, and I just think it's really important for the older body to be seen in this context. So now I've decided that's what I'm going to do. I can't imagine not doing it. So some people ask me, do you think you'll stop? And the answer is no. I'll only stop when I have no more work to show. But I can't imagine that, because I'm already thinking about a new work. So I think that's the point about being an artist, is that it tells you to carry on. You don't tell it. It tells you. It makes your future for you. So you have to follow your instincts and your intuition and your research and your ideas and the things that are important. And this is important for me.
Are there any mummies in the house? Are there any mummies in the house with a large bouncing breast and a cancerous hole where the love once was? Are there any dead mothers in the house?
Look, John, look! See, John, see! Mommy's going to die. Eventually, you knew she would. Ow! You'll get over it. Let's go down the strand of a banana. 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 Let's go down the... Are there any pishy old ladies in...
I think age is but a number. I've never, you know, most of my friends are much younger than me anyway, and I used to teach in a university, so I've always been surrounded by young people, and I like that. I think that's, you know, part of the reason that's held me together. I've always been interested in what's happening in the culture, in society, in the world. I've never sort of given up with that, and I guess that's why also you just think it's illogical to stop.
It's a lot like life, this play between the sheets, with you on top and me underneath. Forget all about quality. Let's play master and servant. Let's know.
Keep
going. You want the nipple?
Just a little,
okay.
Tiny.
A little more. Tiny, because of course when people twist it, it gives it, you know, otherwise it can...
L'alternativa qual è? Quelle due bottole comodissime
yeah,
che
like
hanno fatto
like
in
the end of your penis.
Ma it's not like this.
That's fine.
Like the nipple.
That's lovely. Beautiful.
A little forcing.
It's too much.
Thank you. Never, it's never too much for Joe.
Toss it into the air. That's it. Toss it. That's it. Toss it. And blow on it. That's right. Keep it up. Go on, blow it. Blow it. Go on, get on with it. And now grab it. And bounce it on your neighbour. Go on, bounce it. Bounce it. Bounce it. Bounce it. Go on. Come on, do it. Do it. Here comes the music, so off we go again. That's it. Pass the balloon. Come on, pass it. That's it. Pass it.
Are you okay? Could you put the amplifier up a little bit?
Now I go.
You're fantastic.
And then can I leave 1 hour?
Sure, baby. I'll see you later. Thank
Great.
You very much. Thanks for your help.
Thank you too. You are a champion.
You are. You are a champion.
We'll decide at 9 o'clock.
When I first started, I was touring with punk bands when I was in my 20s. I had a little company with two men, two very tall, 6'5" men and me, and they stood either side of me, and we wore black and yellow stripes and then hats that were 3-foot hats on our heads, so we were like a very tall, weird stripe. A spiral. And we did very short dances to very short, like, thrash, punky, stuff like that. And we were a support act for lots of punk bands. So I used to perform in tiny little pubs and clubs just in front of the drum kit. So the drummer would set up and then there would be that much space and then the audience were there. So I like that sort of whole kind of way of working that I've kept.
Intimate.
Very, that intimate relationship to audience and that proximity to audience and that talking to audience, confrontational, directional work to audience, rather than just making pictures that look pretty. It's much more direct to the audience. We started off working just, I just did everything in clubs and pubs and shitholes, actually. Vile, filthy shitholes. Where nobody would care if you were there or not. And the audience had only come to see the punk bands. They hadn't come to see you. So they would be always spitting and chucking stuff and shouting. But then the Stranglers saw us. You remember the Stranglers? And they liked it. So I went on tour with the Stranglers. So from those little clubs and pubs, they said, will you come on tour with us? And I went, yeah, okay. And then we did Stadium. So we did rock stadiums and like Wembley Arena, Le Zénith in Paris. So 10,000 seater stadiums from these little clubs. Very interesting. Ooh, look at that.
What an angel.
You're an angel. You're an angel. Thank you so much.
Enjoy.
I will.
Are you going to turn that into a dance?
I'm going to turn it into a dance. Thank you.
It makes you blink to stop and think. A woman and a whispering can accomplish so darn much. So never underestimate a woman's touch.